Introverts are masters of their own hidden thoughts and emotions, so they don't have to let the world know what they know and feel. What other people are so confident in saying out loud, introverts find more comfortable in keeping. I'm going to show you the 10 things introverts prefer to keep to themselves. Number 10, their small happiness. Introverts are generally reserved individuals. Thus, instead of publicizing their personal facts, they want people to know and discover them voluntarily. When certain minor events make them indescribably happy, they don't want to flaunt it on social media or even express it to a random person. They prefer to keep things to themselves and celebrate joyous events on their own than celebrating them with someone who doesn't compliment their feelings in the first place. An introvert's happiness is not everyone's happiness. They differ from other people in terms of their sense of fulfillment and contentment. They can be happier purchasing a high-class chess set than buying a party ticket. They can also be more content receiving a journal book rather than a shopping voucher on a holiday season. Do you also keep your sentimentalities to yourself? Number 9. Their hatred towards the ordinary. An introvert's mind is a zone of unconventional ideas. They tend to think things thoroughly and differently than how most people do. However, it doesn't mean they always act according to their idealisms. Introverts are aware that their idealisms may not and may never be a part of their reality. They just enjoy allowing their minds to wander across space and time. That's why it annoys them when people try to interrupt their momentum. They just can't help but depart themselves from the mainstream, because society's values often limit their exploration. This is also why they stare in blank spaces and isolate themselves. Their extraordinary thoughts just couldn't keep up with the world's norms. Number 8. Their deepest imaginations. Introverts might be staying all day in their room, but their minds has already traveled to different places and histories. Because their energy is focused on their inner world, they invest so much time in discovering things within them than being aware of the things happening around them. They play with their realizations, aspirations, and imaginations and fulfill them without anyone's consent. However, why is there a need for them to keep these kinds of thoughts to themselves? It's because they fear misjudgments and ridicules. They're aware that many people might think their imaginations are too weird and immature for their age. Yes, even grown-up or adult introverts still enjoy living with their imaginations unapologetically. So, keeping them a secret is the only way to preserve this inner contentment. Have you ever exposed your unusual imaginations to someone? Number 7. Their dislike for phone calls. Introverts may spend an hour or two entertaining a phone call. However, deep inside, it's a burden to them, especially when it has nothing to do with their interests. They might even feel anxious when their phone suddenly rings, especially when it displays an unknown number. Sudden calls overwhelm them. Thus, if you're calling an introvert, just make sure to text them first before dialing their number. Despite that, introverts would indeed answer calls because they're not irresponsible, neglectful individuals. They know they have duties to fulfill. And if answering a phone call means being a dutiful employee at work, then there's no way they would not answer it. Introverts are aware of their roles and responsibilities amidst their dislikes and discomforts. Number 6. Their self-consciousness. Introverts would never want people to know they feel incredibly self-conscious when shaking a business partner's hand, speaking in front of a crowd, attending a visitor, or even merely talking to an acquaintance. These activities can overwhelm an introvert. Once they have finished performing their out-of-the-comfort-zone tasks, they repeatedly think of those scenarios until they're convinced they've done well enough. In times when they completely mess up a particular event, they can't help but relive the thought of it day and night until they forgive themselves. Introverts may appear unbothered or unaffected by their flaws, but deep inside, they keep thinking about how they could have done or said it better. Number 5. Their realizations. It's enriching for introverts once they've finally completed a whole year's journal. Their daily and weekly realizations are part of their most preserved treasures that no one should ever dare to uncover. Yes, it annoys them when someone continually forces them to open up. The things introverts realize during moments of solitude or self-reflection are not meant to be exposed to the public. They always choose to hide it to themselves. Otherwise, they would feel violated. Introverts hate it when their thoughts are being examined and manipulated by someone else. Unlike extroverts, introverts don't need others' opinions on how things should be done and what events should be internalized. They're the masters of their own thoughts, and they need people to mind their own businesses as well. Number 4. Their dislike for noise, pressure, and shallowness. Introverts might seem fine with having loud people around them. Of course, they would not immediately express their vexations over something that appears to be the normal thing for everyone. It's because they would never want to cause people to think they're odd. Introverts also want to feel they belong sometimes. That's why they tolerate the things that come with it. Their belongingness might mean having to accept noise, pressure, and everyone's shallowness. It might also include accepting mainstream beliefs and practices to cope with the kind of society they're in. However, they can't be in a loud environment for too long. So what would happen when they could no longer take what they used to tolerate? Number 3. Their ideas that are not yet finalized. Introverts only speak or communicate when they have something to say. They only express their opinions and ideas when they're already sure about it. It's somehow awkward for introverts to be called out and asked about their views during a meeting. When everyone makes fun of their quietness, they just go with it by laughing along. However, deep inside, they just don't understand why there's an urgency for someone to speak up when they have nothing relevant to say anyway. Introverts think it's idiocy when people oblige themselves to speak up just for the sake of conforming to a group. They believe it's unnecessary to tell everything you had in mind to soothe the urge to contribute to the topic. Don't get it wrong. Introverts want to share their opinions and ideas, especially when they know it could significantly improve the discussion. Once they're sure about their ideas, they will be more confident expressing them than you might have ever thought. Number 2. Their ability to get stuff done. Almost all the time, introverts want to work alone. They think they can become more productive when they work with minimal supervision or without the presence of other co-workers. However, there are times when their job requires them to associate with many people. Thus, they have to comply with these demands without getting their personal preferences exposed. They can act, jam, and mingle like extroverts and just keep their superiority to themselves. Despite that, they feel more confident in getting things done on their own rather than working with someone who can't get their intuition. It's more challenging for introverts to communicate their thoughts to a group of people rather than executing things by themselves. Do you also find group tasks more draining than individual tasks? Number 1. Their active self-dialogue. This may be their most kept secret among all. Introverts process almost everything they see and hear from their surroundings. They pay close attention to all the sensory details their environment has. Thus, their self-dialogue may contain interactions between them and their environment from the past. They try to retrieve into their long-term memory for some vital information they could use for future purposes. They compare new and old experiences when making smart decisions. Although it could lead to slow actions, they usually make the safest and most carefully thought decisions. Introverts may walk around naturally with all these thought processes, carrying their active self-dialogues in their minds daily. As naturally deep thinkers, an introvert's mind is a vast space for secrets, and they might hate it when someone intrudes their personal space without their consent. Are you an introvert? What other things you don't want people to know?